Hello everybody, once again, this is Akua Kazu. Welcome back to another video. Today I'll be sharing with you what has happened for the past 4 months when I was back at school to study motion graphics design. Just want to show you my progress so far, as well as introduce you to some of my classmates' works. You know, that will be towards the end. And you know, links to their respective Instagram accounts will be in the description below. So do check them out if you like what you see, and give them a follow if you want to see more of, you know, their own progress as well. So what have I been learning so far? Now, when it comes to technical skills, it is actually mainly on 4 softwares. We have your Photoshop, your Illustrator, After Effects, and Cinema 4D. I also learned about a bit about typography, composition, storyboarding, style frames, as well as video production, which I will showcase a video on an interview that we learned to do, you know, lighting, cameras, that kind of stuff. So I'll basically go through with you most of my works in the past 4 months to show you my progress from like a week one, you know, total noob, until now. I think I'm okay. I'm still pretty noob, but I think I'm definitely making good progress. So starting with Photoshop, our first assignment on our first week was to actually learn how to crop, or you know, edit images in that sense, using the pen tool. And the subject here is actually the soccer player that you see with the soccer ball, and we're supposed to crop him out of an asset image that we got and put him in, or you know, Photoshop edit him into certain settings, paying attention to like shadow and lighting, even though we weren't really thought how to do that just yet. So the main idea here is to have a very clean cut of the asset here in question, which is a soccer player using the pen tool, and then placing him in an environment. So what I was trying to do here was an augmented reality kind of thing, which I totally failed, because the status sheet thing that tells you about the player looks really really bad. But given my first work in school, I think it's an okay attempt. I still remember my teacher Martin, when he first saw it, he gave that you know, that kind of like a little spurt of laughter. I think he was laughing at how amateur this thing was. But yeah, I mean that's the start, right? At least I got him to laugh, you know. So on our second week, we were supposed to come up with a perfume advertisement, and we learned more about, you know, cutting out images in that sense using a pen tool. But this time we learned how to cut out images that has a lot of frills, hair, you know, animal fur, cat fur, dog fur. So in my case here, I did a perfume advertisement on normal perfume. It is a Korean brand, and because I wasn't very good with making like an entire, you know, 1920 1080 composition, and I wanted to put to practice all the technical skills that I was taught. So I split it up into 3 different attempts and combine into one. So I'm kind of like cheating here, but I think I did okay. I'm actually pretty proud of this one, granted that it was only 2 weeks in. And I remember that I did a pretty good clean cropping or cutting of the hair using the technique that we were taught. And yeah, if you look at the Green Healing Garden one, the lady was actually not sitting there. She was actually sitting on a piece of log. Yeah, she was from a different image entirely. In fact, all the assets here are all from different places. And yeah, I think I did pretty okay for my second week. So now our third week, we have to pay attention to lighting and some of those like special effects kind of thing. So I did something on the asset here, which is Nike run like you stole something. We learn a bit about a little bit on typography here. We do some very cool thing where you can see the main text, like the R is behind the head of the runner, but it is in front of the arms. Yeah, you can see this in and out thing that you usually see in many design posters out there as well. We actually learn how to do that. It's actually very simple, you just need to do masking. But it's not very good this one, but I try to do something that is akin to, you know, like the Flash. My name is Barry Allen, the fastest, damn it. But you get the idea. So I was trying to do like the Flash thing here, but my teacher told me that light doesn't behave that way. They are more in streaks. I actually started off with streaks of light, but I couldn't make it look nice. So I went in with some wavy kind of light. So this is the best I can do 3 weeks in to my school. So on our fourth week, we have a glitch and disintegration, and I wanted to do something that, you know, that I've been playing, I guess, which is Black Desert Online. So I played the Dark Knight class as well, and I was thinking that it's very cool if I can put her in a setting where she, you know, like Thanos from the Avengers, where he pulls in the moon, right? I think it's the Titan's moon or something. So I wanted to show that she could explode an entire planet with her gravity controlling skills. And the disintegration comes from the debris of the planet exploding, and then the glitch is more like it's so powerful it causes the space-time continuum to like glitch out. So Composition wise, I try to put something in. You can see some framing there with the planets on the top left and top right corner. But overall, the composition is still very bad because there's no contrast. There's just too many things going on in the picture. And you don't really know what's the main focus. Is it the explosion that she's doing? Is it her? So yeah, me, I'm still learning here. And on our fifth week, we have fantasy art. You basically try to find royalty-free stock images online and try to piece together a surreal image, a fantasy surreal image. So you can see I have a statue here. It's actually like greenish in color in like some forest setting. I have a crocodile as well, again in a river, some Amazon setting, and then I have some tribal type people carrying some stuff, you know. So I combine these three different images in a very, very nice cloud setting, try to balance the colors together. You can see in terms of saturation, contrast, composition, yeah, starting to come together a little bit. Yeah, starting to come together a little bit. So I named this piece Pilgrimage actually. So it's surreal because the crocodile scales are like mountains that, you know, pilgrims will actually climb. And then they're actually in a very, very surreal cloud setting, you know, like Siyouji, you imagine, for those who know Journey to the West, if you have watched that before. So that's what I was trying to go on here. But if you actually go check out other very similar surreal fantasy art online, it is much, much better than this one. I've seen some crazy stuff. But yeah, you can go check out if you want to. So for my last one, it wasn't very good because I had to rush this out before my review. I believe I spent like 1 or 2 days to redo my first attempt. So you can see here, it's painted skies. Yeah, and it's for Alpha. I'm supposed to do a vinyl cover for a band. So I did Anthem Lights, and they have an album called Painted Skies. And I was trying to do like a cloud brush. Like I want to do out my own like cloud texture kind of thing. And I wanted to make it a pattern brush kind of thing and then like paint out the sky. So it's like, you know, painted skies, like literally painted skies. But it wasn't applying what we learned. We were supposed to learn like a texture collage style kind of thing in this assignment. So I had to redo the entire thing to like align my work more to what we have learned. And it wasn't very successful. So one of my friends commented that it's okay. It looks very vibrant. It looks very like yangguang, you know, like boys in the sun, that kind of thing. Direct translation from Mandarin, like yangguang nanhai, yeah, sunlight boys, yeah. But if you actually made if the alphabets, you know, the painted skies, if you made it into like, you know, magazine, like maybe there's some black colors, there's some blue colors, there are some other colors in the mix, you would realize that it will be like some of those ransom notes from those kidnappings that you see in the movies. A little bit of that, I guess, but you know, it is what it is. I didn't have a lot of time to work on that one. But that's 6 weeks of Photoshop assignments, essentially. So let's move on to the Illustrator. Yeah, so for Illustrator, in our first week, I actually did... you were supposed to learn something called tracing. So you basically use, like, the pen tool. You use the, like, shape merging tool kind of thing. Basically, all the basic tools in Illustrator to trace an item or anything, because you'll be using that for a lot of your Illustrator works when you actually work with references, that kind of stuff. So the asset in question here is the deer that you see at the center left. Yeah, I was supposed to trace the deer that our teacher provided for us. And then you can change the color, again place the asset in any setting that you want. This was when school first started. It was near like early December, late November, and it was near Christmas. So I was like, hey, why don't I try and trace a Santa Claus, you know, some cabin, some trees, there's a doe at the background. I tried to play with some Gaussian blur with the snow, and then I meant to trace some snowflakes as well. Basically, a lot of things going on. I do not know composition yet in this assignment, since it's also the first week. And yeah, I did some blending, blend two kind of thing, and it was okay. I remember after I did this, I actually got a lot of there were a few people that approached me to do like some freelancing, and I was very surprised because I thought it was only okay. Yeah, like the cabin definitely can be a lot better, but yeah. Week one, we learn tracing, that's what it is. So on our second week, we actually learn album, like we learn to use the blend tool, the pattern brush, and a bunch of other tools as well. And the assignment was supposed to create an emblem, but as you can see on screen, it's not exactly an emblem. So I did like two emblems combined. I was trying to do like a sticker. My initial idea was a spectacle. Yeah, it wasn't supposed to be like a bike. So if you cannot see a cyclist riding on like the bicycle wheels, then yeah, there you go. I'm trying to guide you to see that, okay? So it was supposed to be like a lens initially, like a spectacle lens. So on the left, it will be like Earth doing well, and then on the right, it's another lens where Earth is not doing very well. But I wasn't good enough to make it look like a spectacle, so I went to search for more references online, and I found there was an image about climate change about this guy on a bicycle view. I was like, oh, okay, fits in perfectly with what I was trying to do here. So this was actually my... this is after revision. Yeah, initially when I showed this assignment to my teacher, he said that there were too many colors, so I simplified many things, I improved it, and I made it more balanced. And on the review itself, when I showcased this to my teacher again, as well as like a third party person during our review, that's the point of the review, where it's not only our teacher that will be giving us comments. Yeah, so he mentioned that there's a lot of details on the wheels, but the cyclist is too simple. So yeah, I can definitely add more details to the cyclist to make it look much better. But this is what I had during the review at that time. And moving on, we had a self-branding assignment where we have to like design our own name card. Yeah, so I know this looks quite cool, but it's actually a free template that you can download online wherein it's a Photoshop template. And then you just design your own stuff, and then you can put it inside the folders that they created for you, and you'll all look very nice in this little setting that you see here. And with this, you know, AK is Aikawa Kazoo, so I was trying, it took me a very long time before I had to settle for this, because I was trying to do something more complicated. So I was trying to make use of the Twitch logo. You know, the Twitch logo is like a dialogue box popping out, right? I wanted to do something like the dialogue box popping out, and then, you know, after that, the little thing that pokes in will create a shape. It didn't quite work out. I tried to do it with my cat, because I love cats. Didn't quite work out as well. So in the end, I had to settle with something simple here, something minimalistic. I worked with negative space. Yeah, so you can see the diagonal on the right side of the A is removed, and the vertical part of the K is removed. And I don't know what to do with the center triangular piece yet. So hopefully I figure something out. I'm probably gonna make it look like an accessory, a pen or something like that. That's towards the end of the year, I guess, when I need to work on my showreel. Or I'll totally revamp this entire like branding. But this is what we had. It's a very cool assignment. I enjoyed doing it, even though it almost... it was tough. Yeah, it was tough to come up with something nice that I was proud of. But in the end, you know, simple was what I went for in the end. So after this, we have our first like major assignment. Our first major assignment was something called icon design. And then we have to make use of the icons that we designed and make it into a short animation. Yeah, and using what we have learned from After Effects. Yeah, so I was trying to think of an idea, and my idea was to showcase basically a video to like showcase what I can do as a motion designer when it comes to icons, you know, like not really emotes on Twitch, but more like some branding, some kind of thing. So I did like towards gaming, I have some Twitch logos, I have some Dota 2, CSGO, some PUBG stuff, you know, Battle Royale stuff is very popular now, some gaming peripherals. Yeah, so you can check out the video as I'm talking about it. So it was like very, very basic. I wasn't very, very proud of the end result, because I think I was grappling with time. I needed to design the icons, and I needed to color the icons, and then I needed to animate. And in fact, I spent only like 3 days. Yeah, 3 days to animate, like the last 3 days before the actual review itself to finish it. So I wasn't really that proud of the end result that I got. It was really simple in the end, and there was even a mistake that my teacher pointed out where I didn't actually animate out the headset. So definitely not very proud of this one, but you know, again, you have to start somewhere, right? So the one that I'm really not proud of is the next one that I'm showing you, is an assignment that we did. We learned how to create a 2D character. Yeah, so I just used the character that I had, she designed for me, and I just like trace it, and then I make it into a character, and I make it ready for animation. Yeah, you basically have to create like circles on the joints of the body parts, like the neck, the shoulder blades, the elbows, the wrist, your knees, your ankles, that kind of stuff. And then you have to do, I believe 4 kinematics. Basically, you manually animate your character in After Effects to do like a normal dance, and the dance looks disastrous. Again, I was at the ropes in terms of time, so I was trying to do something simple. Not proud of this one as well, but you have to put what you learn to use, so there you have it. So that's pretty much AI for school. The next thing that we did was Cinema 4D. And for Cinema 4D, the first month or so, we basically did some basic modeling. We learned how to use the deformers, basically things to help you model something. And for me, I modeled what you call a recycling plant. Yeah. So my friends did a lot of different things. Like some of them just did like a nice little machinery and bunch of different tools around. For me, I did like a town. Very, very basic, but yeah, we learn how to do like different rendering. We learn how to deal with like different textures, some of the settings that you do in rendering. So some basic stuff basically to get us familiarized and comfortable with Cinema 4D when it comes to navigating the software. After which we learn how to use effectors. We have to come up with 3 effectors. One of them is text-based. 2 will be, you know, various stuff like, you know, soft body, visual body, that kind of stuff, which you won't understand because those are terms in the software itself. But for me, as you can see on screen, I did some Pokhari Sweat, Night Run, and also some random exploration on the bubbles. And then finally, for the end of the term, we were supposed to model a 3D character. So my reference is from a studio, or a company called Superfiction. You should go Google them, they are very, very nice and good looking 3D models. And I believe they just did a recent advertisement for Nike as well, very, very cool. So you should go check them out if you want to. But I basically used some of the reference there and I modeled a butler cat. So I really like this one because I think it's quite cute in a weird way. Yeah. But it's just a very, very buff, a very jacked out butler. And my storyline for him, if anybody is interested, is that, you know, if you play like Hitman, right? If you play Hitman and you have to disguise yourself, right? So this butler cat is actually disguising himself to finish his job. That's why he's so buff. Or he can just be a very buff butler cat in a, you know, in an anime where he's serving like a family, a very high class family. It's up to you, you know, it's up to your own imagination. But I had a lot of fun modeling this one, and it was tough. Like my initial attempts were really, really bad, which I didn't actually manage to bring home the really, really bad images to show you. But this end result, even though it looks very simple, is like through some blood and sweat. Yeah, again, I'm brand new to character modeling, much less 3D character modeling, and that's all we have. So the main thing, all right, the main thing for this term that we had to do is what we call a branding assignment. So some of my classmates basically did, one of my classmates, Ayumi, she did Vans. Another classmate, Kim, she did Subway. Tianling did Nissin, which is, you know, the cup noodle brand. And Weike did Burger King. So Ayumi, Tianling, Kim, Weike, those are my 4 classmates. And then I'm the 5th classmate in my class. And I'm doing Deliveroo. So why I chose Deliveroo is because when I was streaming, when I was doing YouTube full time in the last 3 years or so, whenever I wanted to get myself some comfort food, I stay in an area where within 15 to 20 minutes of walking, I cannot actually get anything. I cannot go to like a hawker center. Like there's nothing for me to eat 15 to 20 minutes around where I stay. So I always have to order food if I'm hungry and if I want something to comfort myself. And for me, food is my comfort. When I'm stressed, I want to eat something nice. So I'll always use food delivery. So Deliveroo was something that I used personally a lot when I did it. And yeah, I wanted to see what can I do. And I was going for something called isometric. An isometric design or based like video. And you're supposed to keep your video within like 20 or 30 seconds. Because nowadays, if you look at YouTube advertisements or advertisements on the television, it's usually 15 to 30 seconds. So it can actually exceed if you can really make a entertaining 30 seconds or more video. If not, yeah, that's the guideline that we receive. And you know, you have to find out about your brands, like tagline, their history, what's their mission, that kind of stuff, and you have to present. So it's a pretty heavy assignment that we spend 2 months doing. And what I actually had for my first month and then what I actually did for my second month after the initial like presentation, like you basically present something that's like half done and then they'll tell you what should change, what should not change, and then you try to improve on it again, which is really nice because it's like they don't really handhold you, but they give you enough feedback for you to improve gradually until the final product. So I have actually 2 narrations, English and Mandarin. I'll play both, so enjoy that. And yeah, don't cringe too much because it's my best attempt at having a decent narration voice. After which, I also show my classmates' books, and yeah. So do check out their Instagram again. You know, they didn't pay me or anything. I actually asked them in class if they're okay with it, and they said they're okay for me to share their works. And yeah, so if you want to check them out, you know, do check them out, because they're definitely a lot better than me, and I always learn a lot from them as well. So yeah, enjoy. Have a sudden crave for food? With Deliveroo, you can easily fulfill your cravings with the wide variety of choices available to you. Order what you want, when you want, and where you want. All of that will be delivered straight to your doorstep within 15 to 30 minutes. Enjoy food freedom today! with Deliveroo。 肚子饿了，想吃喜爱的美食，户户送多样选择，连你喜爱的 Laksa 都没问题。想点什么，几时点，在哪里点，都为你所愿。点到的美食平均15到30分钟内送到您家门口。感受美食的自由，选用户户送。Last week on Behind the Pixels.
In order to satisfy my ambition, I actually snuck into my neighbor's house just to clean his home. It did not went up well.
And in our final episode.
My name is Nathan. I used to love colors, but now I really, really love shades. My girlfriend left me because I was late 51 out of 50 of my dates. I used to take so long to get ready for dates because I love colors. So now I'm on a new journey to find joy, and that's how I found out about Marie Kondo. As I mentioned just now, I took very long to get ready because I loved colors. I have over 100 colors in my wardrobe in the past, and I take very long to pick what I have to wear. So now I simplified my entire life. I only have 50 shades of gray, light gray, dark gray, and the darkest gray. Many, many shades. Yes, I think I'll recommend Marie Kondo and a Con Marie method to my friends, families, and anyone, any stranger out there. Because this simplification helps you to be on time. And being on time is not just good for dates. Being on time is also good for your work. It's also good when you're catching up with friends or meeting anyone out there. So yeah, I'll recommend the Con Marie method to anyone that I meet. I think just like anyone out there, I'm very thankful. I'm very thankful that now I'm no longer late for any of my work, my dates. And yeah, if you actually know me, I actually found a new girlfriend a while ago because now I'm never late for my dates anymore.
So we have come to the end of the video. And yeah, I think I have a really, really good 4 months in 3D Sense Video School. For those who are wondering where I'm studying, and I'm studying motion graphics design again. And yeah, there's going to be a lot of exciting things to do. There will be TV branding, there will be typography, animation, which we'll be using to come out with a video similar to the Deliveroo one. But for an album, you know, for a band, for a singer, anything, you can even do a lyrical video animation kind of thing if you want to. haven't decided on what I want to do or who I want to do or which band I want to do yet. But you get the idea. There's going to be a lot of things that will be very cool for me to show you all as I progress. Yeah, 8 more months to go and I'll see where it will take me. And yeah, as always, for anyone that's still keeping up to date with what I'm doing, I thank you for being here. And hopefully you enjoy what you see. And as always, my name has been Nakuwaka. So thanks for watching once again. God bless. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care, everyone. God bless. Bye-bye.